Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ravinia Festival. Please note that the taking of photographs, including the use of camera phones and the use of audio or video equipment, is strictly prohibited. As a courtesy to the artist and your fellow patrons, please ensure that all mobile phones, pagers, and anything with an on-off switch have been silenced. We appreciate your consideration. Thank you for making it a great day at Ravinia.
Hi, thanks for being here today in our third masterclass. We're really excited to have John Relier with us today. Before we get started, I just wanted to remind you that tomorrow night we have a Brahms Schumann and Friends concert, and we're really looking forward to that. That's a $10 BGH series here at 6 p.m. And then Saturday we have a free concert at 2 p.m. And Monday is our final concert, and it's going to be Bill Bolcom and Friends. That's another $10 BGH series, so I hope to see as many of you there as possible. And there'll be a Q&A composer discussion moderated by Corey Ellison from our faculty at 5:30. Is that right, Anthony? 5:30. So, and that's always really interesting. So Bill Bolcom will be here. We're really excited about that. For those of you who were at the Haydn last night, the creation, what a special evening that was. And that's one of those events that you say, you know, maybe once in a lifetime, I don't know, and especially with the group of solos we had and Maestro Levine and Chicago Symphony, Ravinia, all the magic happened. And John Relier, who was the bass soloist, I've known John since I was on the music staff at the Met, and I was there with his debut when he sang in Cenerentola. And I told him last night, I said, you've always been great, but holy mackerel, the range and color of your voice, and I was so glad that a lot of our singers were there last night to hear what's possible, the range, you know, in vocalism. So enjoy today, and let's welcome John Relier.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. So masterclasses. My early experiences of masterclasses were kind of a mixed bag as a student. You know, they weren't always about the singers. You know, they were kind of about this singer with a big personality. And sometimes it was like an exercise in public embarrassment or humiliation. But of course, I want to just completely take away that threat right now. Just say that this is a shared experience. You know, I want to help these singers to help themselves, give them some thoughts, some insights that they can take with them, hopefully, that they can get from each other when they watch each other work. It's a workshop, right? So, so help me help you. So here we go. Our first singer is Kara Dugan. There she is. Hi. Very nice to meet you. Yeah. All right. So we are singing Er der Herrlichste der Lieder. Okay.
This is Er der Herrlichste von Allen.
Sorry. Not my rap.
Robert Schumann.
Dort im blauen Tiefel, hell und heil.
My mic is running astray. Wonderful, wonderful, beautiful voice. What I would like to see is if we can go a little further with some of the diction and dynamics, create some more contrast. Like, for instance, when we're in some of these lower passages that are occasionally kind of piano, I'd like to go further towards the diction there. Like, there's this sort of simmering, kind of burgeoning, idealistic, new love and passion going on here. So I want to feel this kind of back and forth of these waves of passion, you know. Very much the way the melody is, we can go to these peaks here, and I don't want those areas to be distracted by a lot of heavy diction or anything like that. Let's be reasonable about it and talk about, you know, maybe go phrase by phrase as we go through it again, and just keeping that in mind. And herrlichsten, these adjectives, and we can really make the most of them, and you can explore a little more of the coloration of the words.
Okay.
At your leisure, whatever's comfortable. I don't want to, like, you have such a beautiful tone, I don't want to mess around with that. So just keep in mind that I'd like to just hear a little extra diction in some of the more subtle passages, the lower passages, even perhaps.
That energy going.
Yeah, just it's this always there,
yeah.
but I want to hear those higher parts of the passage really bloom.
Yeah.
They are. I just want more of a contrast.
Perfect.
Between the lower and higher. Yeah. Can we stop there?
Yeah.
That was great. That's exactly what I was talking about up to there. When we go into the So wie dort in Blaue Tiefe, I want it to just kind of just come back a bit there. And if that means we just do a little rubato there, just so we can get that So wie dort in Blaue Tiefe.
Blaue
Tiefe. And of course, as we ascend in the phrase, you can bloom it again and again. These kinds of these are almost like, I wouldn't say whispers, but there's this contained, this is sort of building kind of passion and love in these lower parts of the passage. So yeah, let's go so wie dort in blaue Tiefe, so wie dort in blaue, you know, just find those sibilances and you know, make the most of them.
Okay.
Yeah, beautiful. The hell und herrlich. Again, I don't want to push this too far, but hell und herrlich, these are really important words, and if we can put a little more air into them, because it's a beautiful tone, and I want to bring a little more of that that kind of passion, that air of passion into it. And you know, not to an overt degree, but I just want those words to stand out with that kind of attitude.
Great.
You know, same spot. Let's try that. One question there. That's wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I don't know if this is illegal, but can we, that final Hell und Herrlich, Herr und Fan, can we use some rubato and make the most of that turn?
Sure.
Because that's where I really hear you, and I want that to really, really shine and come forth. So let's, where shall we take?
Also here?
Yeah. Also, yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, okay. When we say nur in demut in betrachten, we're going to a piano there. So again, I think we're kind of, I mean, in the accompaniment anyway, but I think we could likewise kind of rein in the energy just a little bit, and we say only in meekness. Mm-hmm. So there's this sort of that word, you know, what we've suggested, and then we've kind of backed off there.
Yeah,
and then likewise, what I was saying before, we is that in betrachten, you know, this Demut in betrachten. I want to hear those words stand out a little more. I mean, these are subtle things,
really,
but you plug into them right away, and then it's really really nice how the contrast comes out, and it just kind of sparkles. It has a more of a sculpted sort of shape and definition and contrast. So wandle from there. Maybe just a couple of bars before, so she can be ready. Mein stilles Beten. I think we need to kind of accelerate more through that.
Oh, okay,
I think
sure.
We need to kind of drive it forward,
yeah.
So that when we get to deinem Glück nicht nur geweiht, we kind of back it off a little bit. Similarly, when we say darfst mich niedre Magd nicht kennen, I want to back it off there when we say hoher Stern. Stern der Herrlichkeit, excuse me. there I want a little more of like a sort of little climax there. So in other words, let's slow down a bit there. I'm going to go hoher Stern there. So we can make that Herrlichkeit, make that sort of stand out. So we're going to go Eranich minus Tivis, that whole section. We back off once for Nur Geweiht,
right.
And then we're going to do this. We're going to come back, and then back off again at Hoher Stern der Herrlichkeit. Sorry, that's a lot of info, but it's the same. It's the same structure both times, but a little more stretched out the second.
Yeah, to kind of
yeah exactly. Yeah.
Nicht mein stilles Beten, deine Klicken nur geweiht.
Piano there?
Sorry?
Can we go more piano there and get back to that same principle of the words? And we can kind of, I think we can kind of slow into that upbeat there,
okay,
just to get you prepared.
Great.
For that.
Okay.
So, you don't have to sing the two bars before Stern der Herrlichkeit, we just mark until we get to that bar, whatever. Build that one even more than we did the first time through, so we're really getting really up to our peak. So you can put even more passion into this final final saying of these words, and again just Herrlichsten von allen, like really make the most of those words, because that makes me focus on the text and the meaning. I already know you have a beautiful voice, and it gives me like another 20% more colors. And it's as simple as me just saying it to you, which is fantastic. I'm just, you know, giving you signals, pushing buttons, whatever, and it's great. It makes it easy for me. Yeah, like a bar before the return to air. For your second one? Where were we at for time? Do we have time?
5 minutes.
5 minutes? I just want to hear you sing this. I just want to hear it. So, you know, I might have something to say after, I may not.
But.
Wonderful. Okay. So we're doing, When I'm Laid in Earth.
This is When I'm Laid in Earth from Dino and Aeneas.
Joy.
Thank you very much.
It's really a pleasure.
That was really nice to hear that.
Right.
Okay, thank you. All right. Wow, that was fun. That was easy. These words, I mean, it's finding the words that can really show the voice and give it contrast and color. What do we find first? Do we find the real voice, or does it jump out at us? Do more colors jump out at us through, you know, capitalizing on the text, the color of the text, the color of the emotion behind the text? That's kind of what we're always after, always. So next we have Alex Lawrence. Come on in, Alex. Hi, nice to meet you. So I have a question for you. Are you married to the idea of starting with the Mahler, or, I mean, you can tell me whatever you prefer. I figured...
Well, the Mahler was my plan.
Okay.
It is a bit long, but...
That's not it. I kind of want to... if it's okay, if you're really set on that. Yeah, let's start with the Billy Budd,
sure.
And then we can go on to that.
Sure.
Yeah.
Ain't it all sham? A blur's in my eyes. It is dreaming that I am. But Donald, he has promised to stand by the blank, So I'll shake a friendly hand ere I sink. But no, no, it is dead, then I become to think. Then lash me in a hammock, drop me deep. Fathoms down fathoms, how I dream fast asleep. I feel it stealing.
Your color. It suits the characters so perfectly.
Thank you.
And it's all great. This is going to be the second time I'm going to ask for just some subtle changes. He's kind of in this weird dream state. He's not going in and out of sleep or anything like that, but it's like, I guess most of us know what it's like to kind of be up all night and then just start to feel really just like we're not really there anymore. At least that's been my experience. I don't know what did it, but I'm wondering if we can go after a color, for when you start. It's pianissimo.
Yeah.
Your core is always there, which tells me I don't really want to mess with it too much. I just want to experiment here. And when we say, look, I want you to find a, sort of a stillness, like just, I'm not, am I here? Is this really happening? You know, because obviously he's about to be executed and he's trying to put his reality back in and he has these things all gone. Oh, I'm hungry, you know, I'm gonna die soon. But for the pianissimo, it's like you're kind of in that sort of almost lucid state.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering if you can put a little more, just a little more breathiness into the tone there. Scale it back a little bit and just put a little bit of, yeah, a little more air, I'd say.
Yeah.
Just give it a little duskiness to it. That was very good. I mean, I was already getting something new there. Definitely try it again. What I also want to say is, you know, we clearly have this ocean going on in the accompaniment, and it's fascinating to me because if you look at Peter Grimes, it's almost the same kind of accompaniments going on throughout the opera. I think he obviously had a fascination with this kind of changeability of the ocean and this, that it can be so many things. And here we have this kind of, there's these moments of like when you see a very sort of tranquil kind of ocean, and then it can be very violent, it can be very, you know, there's this upheaval, there's, and this, you see the same thing in Peter Grimes. I think he was just really So we have this ebb and flow, which we hear in the accompaniment. So when you get, and I don't want to add too much just yet, but we'll see how far we go. But these kind of this gravity, you have to feel the kind of wave sort of coming forth, rather than thinking of it kind of in a horizontal,
yeah,
or whichever, just a linear way. There's a gravity as these things happen. But let's just see how far we can go with that color, and you know, no more than you're comfortable doing.
Okay.
Yeah. Can we try that with a little more of that color?
Yeah.
I mean,
sure.
I'm not sure if that sort of feels like a low to middle break for you. If that's, do you know what I mean?
No. Yeah.
Because sometimes it's tough to do that in the transitional parts of the range.
I think the main thing is I was warming up with the Mahler and transitioning.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Just changing gears a bit.
All right. So, okay. No, I get it. I get it. I'm sorry. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I chose this because I wanted to kind of get a real idea of the core and the line of your voice before we kind of did acrobatics with it, you know. Yeah, okay.
It keeps the gods godless and silvers this nook.
Good. Yeah.
In terms of the hands, you know, he's chained up in this scene.
Yeah, yeah.
And in an audition format, I'm not quite always sure whether it's more effective to portray him that way.
I don't think that really matters. I think this is not really something that matters. I think we just want to hear. I just want to hear the character come through the voice, and I think that's what most people would be thinking. Yeah. You know, you have a very good calm physicality, so I think any director can see that they can do with whatever with that.
Yeah.
So I mean, it'd be one thing if you came into an audition and you were doing all this kind of stuff, you know, but you know, just by not seeing that tells me you have the neutrality to just say, stage me, and we'll deal with it then.
Sometimes too neutral, actually. I feel like I don't, you know.
Yeah, well, I don't
use my body to full effect, but you know, this might feel a little stiff, so that's why I asked.
I mean, in terms of getting the character, I understand, like, you know, you were warming up with something completely different, but I mean, I was hearing what I was after. You know, this. There's a stillness, a kind of a, I don't know if the word is resignation, but there's just this kind of trance going on.
Yeah.
And so I want the words, the vowels and the words to kind of get a little finer, a little more of a pinpoint in the sound. You can just say, I guess you have two choices.
Yeah.
You can go for that pianissimo just with a smaller sound, mm-hmm. or you can add to it also a little bit more air. But I know that's a slippery slope sometimes with anyone, you know. So you can make that choice for yourself. But when we get to these eyes up and I must up to this stuff, this is where, oh my gosh, the waves are just suddenly picked up. The boat's going like this, but it's also metaphoric to this, you coming out of this this sort of half there kind of state into, oh my gosh, you know, wow, I'm here and this is really happening. So, but you're almost imitating this sudden kind of flow of waves.
Yeah.
There's a gravity there. There's a kind of, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
So why don't we, are you comfortable? Sure, sure, you want to, unless you want to prepare for that a little more. Let's try from But Will Die and start with that smaller and make a real crescendo out of that. Start with it kind of towards what we were saying with a pinpoint of sound. Yeah, exactly. You've come back to reality. Oh my God, I'm back in my body. I'm hungry. And again, we have this, it's this, you know, this momentum suddenly picking up. You know, it's, we're not kind of in this steady sort of symmetrical kind of, you know, 6-8 necessarily. And the weight comes in and out, and he's written that into the crescendo and decrescendo.
Yeah.
And empty stomach now. I want to say, like, do that much with it, but that's the idea. There's a,
right.
You know?
Right.
And I don't mean like a color, I just mean a vocal kind of weight.
Yeah, yeah.
It doesn't mean you gotta put it all into one long, heavy bow. It just means, you know, it's kind of like that. So let's try it from the. That was all wonderful. That very last phrase, we're back to triple piano.
Yeah.
And you had the color I wanted in that phrase near the end of it, when you say the running of me up. You know, we can go back to the this kind of almost, it's parlando, but it's almost like a voix me kind of thing, like a mixed. And you had that, like I said, towards the end of that phrase. I want to hear it throughout that phrase. And heaven knows who will have the running of me up. You know.
Heaven knows who will have the running of me up. No pipe to those haggards. But ain't it all sham?
Can we do that? Can we do that more like a whisper?
More whisper.
But ain't it all? Like, we're not. I'm sorry. there's points here where we're parlando or we're doing these kinds of, you know, just kind of Sprechstimme kind of things here.
Yeah.
And it's not necessarily about, we're not going for beauty.
Yeah.
We're back to the words and the drama that's happening. And then you can go back into that. Let's try it from there. Just a couple of bars before Bereng Dola Shem. It's just character stuff. I mean, the voice is all there, and the capability is completely there. I'm just, you know, I'm splitting hairs here. Yeah.
But ain't it all sham? A blur's in my eyes. It is dreaming that I am. But Donald, he has promised to stand by the blank. So I'll shake a friendly hand ere I sink. But no, no.
I don't want you to feel like you're in danger of that.
Yeah,
no, absolutely. Like, this is experimenting here. We're just kind of seeing where your comfort zone is there, and nobody should ever push you beyond it, and least of all me. I'm not here to do that. So, so you were thinking from... but Donald, he has promised. Is that where you were thinking from?
Yeah.
So you, yeah, it's piano espressivo, and we crescendo. That's all. It's starting at a small point, and then bringing up to the core near the end of that. But no. And then if you can, get back to a more.
Okay.
I'm trying to think of the word for this. There's just a stillness, and you can maybe put it in your body, in your breathing. The breathing doesn't have to prepare like it would for a phrase where you're bringing out your core and really coming to a climactic point in the melody. So when you get to but no, you can just let things just kind of settle.
Okay.
And then you can either choose to keep that the more breathy quality, or you can just go to a smaller vowel,
okay,
a little pinpoint of sound. But you can keep your real voice there if that's what you feel best doing. If you want to start from Buck Donald.
Just the measure before.
Yeah.
But Donald, he has promised to stand by the blank. So I'll shake a friendly hand ere I sink. But no, no, it is dead, then I'll become to think. They'll lash me in a hammock, drop me deep.
More piano here.
Fathoms down fathoms, how our dream fast asleep. I feel it stealing
Okay, so Hagar. There she is. Hi. Nice to meet you. Thank you. So we're doing a boat shaft here. Okay. It's a very rich sound, and at the same time, when you go up there, it really sparkles and shines. It's gorgeous. It really is. And again, you know, I really don't have a lot to shift here. I don't want to shift anything. And again, I mean, I think, like we were talking about before, and I think for you, this is something we need to talk about in terms of when you're down and kind of in your lower register there. Mm-hmm. And I want to see if this is possible for you, if you can think of it a little brighter.
Yes.
Just a little brighter down there. Because I'm kind of losing a little bit of the voice there, but I don't want to force it. Yeah. But if we can keep it closer to the color that you get up to, make it a kind of like a foreshadowing of that color. Mm-hmm. So that you're kind of We can see where you're going with this, because the mood is kind of the same, you know. There's this, you know, I want to hold this breeze here, and you know, and send it forth and stay with her, and you know. So the idea of it's I wouldn't say like a whisper, but it's, I'm not saying in terms of color, but in mood, and when you talk intimately, you're going to bring more of the brightness of the words forth, so that we can really capture that. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, let's start from the beginning again.
Thank you.
great. Can I stop you there? When you start, that was really great up to there. I would say there was maybe just a couple. No. When you start the Tutsi Dan section there, mm-hmm. can you start more piano?
Yeah.
And
I feel like I'm pushing it forward.
Yeah. How do you feel about us just going a hair slower? What do you think about that? Because that might give you, at least for the moment, some time to negotiate those changes. All right,
yes.
So let's start from, what is it, 4 bars before that section. Let's go a little slower.
Don't push. I tell myself not to.
Yeah, but you definitely you definitely started more piano there. And I would say something, did you feel like you were running out of energy or
I felt I wasn't sure I can keep
let me just give you an idea there. We're not going to give the same weight to each word.
Yeah.
And what I don't mean is, okay, that's lighter, that's lighter. Think of them as separate bows.
Yes.
So, to see, don. I mean, I'm not saying, but the chords are going to be like, hey, I got a little bit of rest. And you can work that into a piano without feeling, I've got to be quiet now.
Yes.
So, take it more like, to see, don. You know, it's like a little, maybe a viola solo or something like that. But yeah, then we can start piano and it doesn't cost us, you know. Yeah, let's try the same point again. Better?
Yes.
Yeah.
It did, yes.
That was great. That was great. And I mean, maybe this section, could actually move a little quicker. Would that be more comfortable? This point.
I think it was good
to back it off a little bit.
Feel it.
Then maybe you can go back up in tempo if that feels comfortable down the road.
Right.
But you're not breaking any rules here. So, all right, let's go on. Let's go on. Yeah, so just take that idea that we're not forcing all the words onto one bow, because then the chords say, I'm going to just hold on to this.
Yeah.
So we can take the unaccented syllables and treat them like the end of the bow.
Right.
And we start the bow just the same time we're getting the breath in, so we won't hold the breath and start. The bow starts on the smallest portion of the vowel. It's just going to, but if you keep that in mind, that there's these little vacations for the voice in between notes or phrases, then you won't feel so kind of built up. But it sounds wonderful, really.
Thank you.
That's great. Let's go on. This is, we're doing Voi che sapete? Yeah, okay. Wonderful.
Another boy.
Yeah. Coming after the song, I'm sure it's kind of tricky to kind of get back to a vulnerable place, right?
Yeah.
And this would have been another case where I might have asked for this first, because I would like to see how far you can go with using a little less volume in a couple sections.
Okay.
So the Voi che sapete, you know, he's in front of the Contessa, so he's... at first, he's very shy, as we know, when he comes into the room. It's all a bit of a pushing the envelope, because he's in her chambers, you know. And that's already kind of putting somebody in a very, very delicate place. But, you know, we see later on, of course, and we know that he has a thing for the Contessa. But what I want is a more of a contrast before we get to the sospireggiamo, because this is where he can't hold himself back now. He's been kind of holding it back a little, or just been kind of like, okay, I'm just gonna sing this for you now, and then, oh, you know, this is building up of hormones. You know, he's discovering this whole thing of adolescence. You know, it's a I have a 14 and 16 year old, so. Enough said. So, boys. Yeah.
I don't think girls are any better, though. Yeah.
Yeah, so if, yeah, let's just relax for a second, we can start it again.
Yeah.
You feel comfortable with that tempo, though, right? That's comfortable for you. Okay. And again,
I was a little late. I was like a little bit
right.
Checking myself all the time or something.
But again, I think you can economize with that same idea of
right.
taking the weight off on the unstressed syllables and, you know, the less important words.
Yeah.
Okay, so like we have this, the importance of the text being on kind of the downbeat of each of these bars, you know, voi che sapete, you know, so we can treat that, you know, just that make sure that the weight doesn't stay the same in the voice throughout the phrase, that we can play with it, and that will save you energy, and then you can, you know, maybe start. Let's just try starting a little quieter, but not to any degree that you feel uncomfortable with. That was wonderful, really wonderful. That I think that we were there. When a good example is a do ne vede. I'm exaggerating,
yeah.
But that's the voice, the vocal kind of weight coming off and on. It's a way to keep the chords coming back together. I'm exaggerating, but it's more of a physicality that you can feel. That will save you up. So when you get to we want to bring it back after Cielo nel cor. But that was great. I want to hear more of what you're doing with the Donne Vedete, kind of in the general rhythmic structure, with the attitude of the weight and the voice. But that, we don't need to do that again.
The reprise.
Yes. Yeah. Let me see here. Where would you like to go?
Would you like to do the fast part as well, or just that beginning?
Let's continue to where we left off.
Okay.
Yeah, from where we left off. How are you feeling? You.
Sento.
Yeah. Okay. That's good. Yeah, that's what I'm after. I want to see if you can go back to that.
Yes.
because it's almost like, oh my God, I gave away too much,
yeah.
like of my feelings to you, and I just really made it. Okay, I'm back in your bedroom, and
yes.
Sorry, you know, yeah. So,
From languir così or?
What do you feel comfortable doing? The sospire gemo.
Yeah.
Do you feel comfortable doing that again?
Yes.
And yeah, put a lot of the hormones. Put the hormones in there. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Sospiro e tremo senza voler, palpito e tremo senza saper, non trovo pagina né redi, ma pur mi piace, non puir quasi. Poi che sapete,
my name is Rhys Lloyd Talbot, and I will be singing the fourth of Brahms' serious songs.
Thank you.
Bravo. Really good. Yeah, you know, I love the color you have. What I would like to see is if we can capitalize on some of the more lyric qualities we want to get in, sure. in the text. Namely, any time we talk about, but we don't, you know, without love, it's nothing. The word. And this is a small detail, but when you say Liebe, anytime you get back to that, you know, because there's this kind of, oh God, you know, I can be, you know, I can be a hero, I can do noble things, I can, you know, I can have faith, I can be righteous, but none of it means anything. I can glory, none of it means anything. Compared to love, and it has no meaning. So I like the dark colors you have there because it sort of illustrates this feeling of, you know, I can do this, I can do that, but if it's just, you know, without love, you know, that we can. I want to see if you can. I don't know if I want to say sing brighter on those passages because I don't want to mess with your timbre, but I would say maybe go for something a little more. Lyrical and feed a more of a dolce sound into it.
Sure.
I don't know, like, do you, we'll get to it, we'll get to it. Yeah, so.
All right.
Tönen der Tode eine klingende Schelle.
Okay, sorry. That's great. That's what I was talking about. And when you say so wäre ich ein tönend Erz oder eine klingende Schelle, this is like, yeah, if you don't have love, then no, this is, you know, all this great talk and profound things I might say, they're just noise. They're just noise. It's like a gong or a crashing cymbal or something like that. So just word painting, and I know this is in a low register for you, but it wouldn't probably cost you anything, just a kling and a shen, you know.
Sure.
This is suggesting that they're very suggestive of the sounds, you know. It's all just noise, with the, you know, a gong or a clingy cymbal. So just, yeah, articulate that. So like, are you comfortable coming in at und hätte der Liebe nicht? Because we can create the contrast. We can start that with a very lyric quality because we're talking about, oh, I want, you know, we need love, you know. And then it's a very shiny turn. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Let's try that. From Redete, I guess, and you don't have to start on those words, but just so you can be prepared to start that. Unless you're comfortable to starting again. Whatever's easiest for you.
Got it.
Okay.
Alle Geheimnisse
wird er dir lieben nicht, so wäre ich nicht, so wären Fäden nicht. Und wenn ich alle meine haben, den Armen geben und ließe meine Leib brennen, meine Leib brennen. Und hätte er dir Liebe nicht, so wären wir's nicht nützen.
That's great. Let's stop you there. Yeah, I like that. We're getting some good contrast there. And this upcoming section, I think, is probably the most important part of the poetry. This idea of looking through a glass darkly, it's such a kind of an interesting, kind of enigmatic thing, you know. But this kind of sums up, is he's looked into a mirror and seen this obscured self, you know, image or image of reality, and seen that it's kind of an illusion. All these things that he thought were so important to attain in life, they really don't mean anything, because what he really sees in that mirror now, in truth, is love. You know, this is his ultimate meaning. So again, go for this lyricism here, you know, because this is a really, really important moment. It's sort of in this suspension of memory and realization. So try to make it as lyrical, or I don't know if you, because I mean we speak. We try to find the kind of terminologies that we can each kind of relate to. If you're looking, if you would think brighter, I don't know, or if you would say sweeter, in terms of just how your voice feels to you. I just really want to feel this line here, you know, and if that means going towards a sweeter quality, so you can do this. Let's start at the adagio then. Wir sehen jetzt. Maybe just get ready for it with the two bars before.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wir sehen jetzt durch einen Spiegel in einen dunklen Vorhang.
It's exactly what I was thinking of. Now there's a real new impact coming through from the phrasing and what you're doing when you're finding a more lyrical color. And I mean, you have, it sounds very comfortable for you too. I would say just, you know, maybe when you sing that last phrase, Dann aber werd ich erkennen, get a breath after erkennen, so you're comfortable with what follows, the gleich wie ich, and you can be comfortable on that turn there. you'll have a lot more in reserve, and then you can kind of, you know, not feel kind of like it. You've got to kind of just go straight through those last two bars to keep your energy. So if you can try this, just take a nice breath before gleich wie ich, so we can kind of maybe just do a slight holding back with the accompaniment there, just a hair, so you can get that breath in there and prepare yourself. So yeah, do you want to start from jetzt erkenne ich stückweise? Yeah. So that's great. What I'm noticing is I hear even more of your core, or this kind of smooth kind of quality coming through when you capitalize on the voiced consonants.
Yeah.
I think at times you're kind of going through them and they're just a little more of an obstacle than they should be. Obviously they shouldn't, but and I just want to start from the Nun aber bleibet Glaube, Hoffnung. Keep what I just said in mind for Liebe, and you can just keep that in mind in general with singing the language. I don't know if you feel comfortable with this, when you say Glaube, Hoffnung, like really separate those words. And just so that, because these are kind of the penultimate thoughts, the kind of themes that are versus love. Love is more important, but the Glaube, it's, you know, useless. Hope. Just point those words out in a slightly more dramatic way. That would be great.
Sure.
From Nun aber bleibet.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much. So, here we are at the, this is a really interesting pairing of pieces. You know, there's a theme there. So, our next, we have Katie Jordan. Is that right? Hi. Very nice to meet you. I love this song.
So I will be singing Waldesgespräch from Schumann's Liederkreis.
Wonderful. I want to just see something here. When you start your first passage as Lorelei, Gross ist der Männer Druck und List, let's capitalize on the most feminine and seductive sound you can get here. Mm-hmm. And let's then build the rest of it around those parts. Mm-hmm. It's not so much that I'm after a contrast. I just want to hear those as the most beautiful and seductive passages in the song. And I know that it's, you're just settling in. So, but those are easier phrases to kind of warm up into, mm-hmm. because that's where your real sound is, you know. But I do like the contrast between the man and the woman here. So. Let's just, as an exercise, let's just start with Gross ist der Männer Trug und List, and let's just do that section for up to Du weißt nicht wer ich bin. Yeah.
Gross ist der Männer Trug und List, vor Schmerz mein Herz gebrochen ist.
That's right.
Wohlhier das Wahl von. I'm wondering if we can just round out the vowels a little bit from in general. I don't want to tell you to darken the voice. Obviously, that's not a good way to do this. But just thinking of a little bit rounder. And see if you can start with a stillness of there's this kind of suspension of okay, there she is. She's the siren, you know. She's this image in front of this man, and we know what the sirens do. You know, they lure them to their death, and by doing that, you know, in doing that, we want to hear her seduce them. And would it help to go just a little quicker there so you can turn it into a longer line?
Yeah. Maybe.
Let's just experiment with that. Not much quicker, just yeah, something a little more like that. So again, that's what I'm after, and I'm sorry I'm skipping to her bits here, but I think in doing that we can eventually have her really stand out in terms of the character, and these are like suspended moments in a way whenever she comes in. You know, so let's try it from du kennst mich wohl, yeah, and we'll be seductive there, and so when we get into es ist schon spät, we have a bigger contrast. There's like, you know, it's getting late, you better get out of here or you're dead,
yeah.
You know, so we can be seduced, have the seductive quality up till that point.
Sure.
And it won't cost you as much. Tom, du kennst ja.
Du kennst mich wohl, du kennst mich wohl, von hohem Stein schaut still mein Schloss tief in den Rhein. Es ist schon spät, es ist schon kalt. Kommst nimmer mehr aus diesem Bett, nimmer mehr aus diesem.
That's great. That's really great. How did that feel,
yeah.
Tempo-wise?
Good.
Yeah. Okay. Do you want to go on to the musetta, or
sure.
Or do you want to? Yeah. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Oh.
fantastic. I mean, it's really beautifully sung. I mean, I think it's a highly underestimated piece for a lot of singers. You know, a lot of sopranos, it's not easy, right? I mean, you make it sound very easy. What I just wanted to address is, you know, maybe exploring a couple more dimensions of the character. What I like about what you're doing is you're not playing it like a, you know, run-of-the-mill coquettish, you know, style, which isn't right. It, of course, she is, you know, trying to make a presentation of herself, but she wants the attention. She wants to make him jealous. But I think if we could make an epilogue in the opera, we would probably see that she eventually, she and Marcello would be back together, and eventually she'd probably eventually make him lose his mind. She would destroy him. So I think there is definitely a dangerous factor here. We've seen how she is, you know, later on, she's full of fire, you know, and that's what is so alluring about her. And but she's, you know, it's just like Lorelei in the previous piece. She's dangerous, just to put it simply. You know, I really think that that's part of this. And so I think, can we put a little more of this, put more sexuality into it, but kind of a, just not like right out front, but just a feeling of sensuality, something like that. So maybe if that means shaping the vowels as you go on a little more, like just really keeping them spinning, or how do I put it? Just taste them more, and just, yeah. I don't know if that makes sense, but let's try that again. I think that's absolutely right.
Okay.
Like I'm getting more of that. There's this. It's not just about making a scene in the cafe. There's a sense that she's really in control at this particular moment, and I just want to have that feeling throughout. And you had that going. I just wanted to bring that up now,
okay.
Because the attitude should never be like, oh, you know, it's like, okay, this is what I'm gonna say to you, you know, and I'm gonna make you lose your mind. I'm gonna drive you nuts. And so there's that element of dangerous sexuality and control, you know. So where do you wanna, should we just go from E la bellezza mia? Yeah. And it can save you, I'm sorry, it can save you energy for the climaxes. What's that? Yeah,
just
good.
Good.
Yeah. And then those sections, you know, the high notes and everything will really stand out, you know, because then we see these images of what she's really like, you know. Maybe I've made her too crazy, I don't know. All right. From E la bellezza mia. No time for me to speak here, and these rests are too short. Yeah, that's exactly it. I think, yeah, are you noticing that it's helping you kind of get back to the center of your voice?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like hearing a more of a connection of sound now. There's like a real focus. That energy just kind of helps bring things back to a focus. That's what's great here, is you sense that you control the scene, and with that focus comes a vocal poise. So we can, what I was saying just there before I rudely interrupted you, or as I rudely interrupted you, the così le fluvio, that's like a surge of this, you know, like, I'm really gonna get you now. So that you've come out of you know, and it's now it's like, I'm really gonna lay it on thick. You can maybe be a little more humorous here, I think. Yeah.
More what?
Maybe a little more ironic here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure.
So yeah. I think that really put a real nice finish on the voice for that particular number, because I wanted to hear more of that pureness, and by virtue of making the character somebody who isn't just running around flirting and making some cute scene in the cafe, it's actually there's more of a dangerous quality to her. And with that, the focus, the dramatic focus of her is, I mean, you can really just say it's all on him, you know. I'm gonna say this now and see what you think. You know, it's not like, hey, no, no, you know. That can take the voice off of itself if you're just strutting around and trying to be, you know, a scene. So that was really good. Bravo. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. It was a really, really talented group. I mean, I was struggling there to find things to say, to be quite honest. You know, it's so nice when you can just say little interpretive things and then the rest just sort of falls into place, you know. Wow. Yeah, I'm really, really impressed. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.